Okay, so let's get back to this. Before I leave it, one last thing I wanted to do then is that this is a multi-stage, and we only talked about two separate stages, this one with load, this one seeing that, Q2, and then Q2 with nothing loaded on it. So in that case, the truth is, what is the overall gain, or let's call it overall, what is the overall gain? And it is equal to, in this case here, AV1 plus AV2, as long as these are both in dB. If they were just the numbers that we had, the hundreds, where we had the individual gains without taking the log of it, then you would multiply the two together. But because logs are exponents, as you know, when you multiply with common bases, you just add exponents together. So the total gain then, in this case here, would be 45.8 plus 34.4, 2 carry 1, 35, 45, 70, 80, 80.2. 81, that type of number. So you just add the two together to get the overall gain. What did we say? We said 0.2, is that right? Carry 1, 80 dB, all right? Okay. All right, now let's just see if we can change this circuit a little bit. So what I want to do is I'm going to capacitively couple now, and I'm going to come down here with a so-called stiff voltage divider. And what do I want to give it? Let's say, how about 33K? And I'm going to make this 8.2K. So in this case here, what I'm going to point out is, and we can go through the DC setup again, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to leave that for you to do. We have basically 8.2K over 33K plus 8.2K times 12 volts to come up with a V at this point. We drop 0.7, we get V at the emitter. This voltage over this resistor gets us a current. This current through this resistor is a voltage drop. Subtract that voltage drop from 12 volts, you got the voltage here, which you know the voltage out. Take this current, the emitter current that you've calculated, and then divide it into 25 millivolts to come up with your RE2 prime. It's going to be a new one, so I'm going to call it second. It's going to give you another new number. Now, here's the point I'm trying to make here is that this total gain of 80.2 was direct coupled. What this circuit is now seeing is this resistor, RC1, in parallel with R3, in parallel with R4, in parallel with beta RE2. All right? All of that divided by RE prime 1. So let's look at that. I said RC here, 1. In parallel with R3, in parallel with R4, in parallel with beta RE prime. All of that over RE1 prime. And that will now be the gain. You take this for 1 with load, right here. And that will change. That number will change. If you actually do the math, and I would like you to do the math, you'll see now that as a result of being capacitively coupled, this gain now is equal to 33.9 dB. So the extra load has dropped it almost 0.5 dB. Not a lot, but it's there. So what you need to do is you've got to go through the DC setup to come up with the R sub E prime setup, and then use that and plug it in to a formula like this would probably be given to you on an exam, simply because it's you can get lost in, oh, I'm shorting this to that, this gets shorted to ground, that's to ground, this goes to ground, okay, oh, they're all in parallel. So we tend to simplify that with the formulas that we can give to you. So that, I want to leave that with you. I don't think there's a lot to say other than if we actually did this calculation again, just so that when you're doing it yourself, you'll find the number is 148.1 ohms with the new one. You'll find that IE2, as a result, if you do the calculation, will be 168 microamps. And the voltage here, well, it's basically going to be this minus 0.7 is going to be 1.69 volts. And the base voltage, of course, this was VB2 is 2.39 volts. So go through that. That's your homework, is to go and make sure that your calculations come up the same as mine, all right? And you get your DC parts. I'm pretty comfortable with that. You, by this time in the video series, you're familiar with the DC parts. The next thing is to try and keep track of the AC parts so that you've got the proper loads in place so that you can complete the gain equations appropriately. Okay, I'm going to move on to a different type of device now. These are bipolar junction transistors, so these are multi-stage BJT transistors. This happened to be common emitter circuits. Okay, the emitter is common to the input and the output, so the signal's taken off the collector for a common emitter circuit. Be careful when you're looking at your formulas that you're not looking at, say for example, if I took the output off the emitter resistor, this would be a common collector. So make sure that you're looking at gain formulas appropriately to the circuit configuration. But this is a good overview as to how these amplifiers work. If you need to know what is the current gain because you want to know the power gain, well, basically, there's your current gain right there. BJTs are current amplifiers. Base in multiplied by beta gives you collector current out. So if you multiply 125 times the gain or take it to the log, base 10, 20 log of that, and add that to the, if you multiply the current gain times the voltage gain, you'll get the power gain, okay? And if you do that at logs, you will add them together. Okay, I'm gonna leave that alone. I think that's a very good comprehensive understanding of bipolar junction transistor multistage amplifiers. And let's move on to the final topic of the course, which is the enhancement metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor.